Let's then move on and talk about one of the corporates that's on our radar this morning. The company is Honasa Consumer. Now, Honasa has entered the personal wash space with their new launch, which is the Mama Earth Moisturizing Lotion Soaps. To talk about this and the sort of implications for the business, we have Varun Alag, chairman at Honasa Consumer, with us. Varun, good morning. Great to have you on. So, interesting category that you're getting in. Lots of new categories, actually, that Mama Earth is now targeting, right? So, tell us about personal wash, because, again, once again here, you'll be taking on a lot of the established giants, but you've done that well with a lot of your other brands. So, wonder if this, will be pretty much the same. But just give us the size of the category, how much you're looking to invest here, and what are the timelines that you're working with?
Hi, thank you so much for having me on the show. We're no newbies to entering categories where giants have already been there. But I think we've always found a way to differentiate our products, provide toxin-free propositions with the goodness of nature that Mama Earth has, and consumers have loved our products in other categories. So this is a category which we've been eyeing for some time. It is almost a 25,000 crore category in India, one of the largest categories in beauty and personal care. This is a category where, like you rightly said, there have been a lot of strong brands, but naturals brands as a play is something which we are trying to target with and differentiate with. And like you rightly said, it's a moisturizing lotion soap that we have launched. So it's a non-drying soap, and a lot of consumers that we came across were using soaps and then needed body moisturizers because the soap would dry their bodies. So I think that is the problem that we are trying to solve it with our soaps. And we've launched them in multiple different natural variants like Upton, Multani, Mitti, etc., which are core to the Indian cultural heritage.
No, Varun, absolutely. I guess you folks have a knack for finding the consumer problem and then trying to address it. I think that's why the brands do what they do. But just in terms of numbers, now, typically at a company level, your ad rates, I think, have been running around that 30% of percent of sales sort of a mark. Now, when you launch a brand like the one that you're launching now, how much do ad spends go up by at a blended company level, and particularly for that category? I don't know if you slice it down as per individual brand. So just want to get a sense of the kind of investments that will go in as you're in the launch phase.
Well, actually, that's the difference about our model. And our model does not rely on a very explosive advertising budget to start with. And our advertising strategy is very digital oriented, targeted in nature, right? Even when we do regional, we're able to find the right kind of TG to which we are able to reach through targeted digital mediums, right? And hence, it's more of a variable model where as the brand or the category grows, our investment sort of grows along with it in terms of percentage. So in that sense, what we have been sticking to at a company level, even with investing in building some of these new categories, we will stick to some of those levels. There can be minor short-term variabilities, but in the long-term, the trajectory that we have been on, where we've been getting better on our A&P spends and hence getting better on our EBITDAs, will continue even after entering into some of these categories.
Okay, you said there could be minor short-term increases. Can you just quantify that? I mean, just for our benefit, so 30%, 34%, 35%. I mean, what are we looking at just in terms of the ad sales budget as you go forward and step into FY25?
No, I think as we get into FY25, like I said, in terms of overall trajectory, we are going to get better compared to FY24.
Varun, morning, Prashant here.
Morning.
The 25,000 crore market, that is the personal wash or is that the moisturizing lotion market? I mean,
let me clarify, right? The 25,000 crore market is the personal wash market, okay, which is basically soaps and body washes, right?
Okay.
The product that we have launched is actually a soap bar, right? But we're calling it a moisturizing lotion bar because of the amount of moisturizing ingredients that we have added into it. And hence that's the differentiation. But finally, it is a soap bar. It's playing in the same occasion where consumers are using a soap, but providing a differentiated experience.
Okay, all right. No, I mean, then, sorry, I was just wondering. Varun, just one thing. Last time we spoke with you exactly a month back, and at that point you'd said that there is some slowdown which is creeping into urban markets as well. You said that you'll do much better than whatever category growth rates, etc., will be. How has that panned out since the last time we spoke? I mean, is that getting entrenched, the slowdown a little bit in urban markets?
No, honestly, summer opening up has been fairly positive. And I think December, January is when we had seen I would call it very high competitive intensity because of the slowdown for larger companies in other markets and that discounting, etc., increasing. And come March and opening up of summer, we are actually seeing a fairly strong demand coming back, and we are hopeful as we get into the next year, all of that should be past us.
Okay, all right. Varun, short but sweet conversation. Thanks a lot for joining in and giving us a brief insight into these new plans as well. We'd like to talk a little bit longer, but maybe in the coming weeks we can reconnect.